Ja, hallo und herzlich willkommen zurück zu Shadow One Hong Kong. Wir sind hier immer noch in Whampoa bei der Mordermittlung. Wir gucken, jemanden. Ne. Was haben wir denn vor? Wir wollen uns den Laden von Magpie angucken und die Gangers. Die haben wir, glaube ich, schon. War das nicht irgendwas mit einer Garage hier irgendwo? Die waren da hier, oder? Wahrscheinlich. Irgendwie verbinde ich die mit Garage. Warum? Weiß ich nicht mehr. Hat uns wahrscheinlich irgendjemand erzählt. Dann würde ich sagen, gucken wir hier mal rein. Guten Tag, die Herrschaften. Wir kommen in Frieden. That's far enough, guy. The woman hefts her weapon, tossing a nod toward the gangers behind her. This lot's our turf. If you're looking for a fix, you're welcome to trade. If you're not here for business, clear the hell out. You try and wander around on our turf, we're gonna have to air you out. So what do you say? You're looking for a little pick-me-up, a little nitro to give you some pep? Maybe you want some chips? Take the edge off. You want it? I got it. Offensichtlich spielen wir nicht in England. Entschuldigung. Show me what you have. Jazz ist eigentlich die einzige Droge, die so richtig Nutzen bringt, finde ich. Aber brauchen wir nicht. Attack them? Nee. What happened in the fight here? As far as I know, some police showed up looking for somebody. They got in here, all of them got killed. Whoever they were after was long gone by the time we showed up. Used to be a lot of Wampones living here. They all cleared out, muttering about ghosts and shit like that. Ach, ihr habt die gar nicht erschossen. Also? Have you heard anything else about the murders? Nothing much. I tell you what, though. I've got a guy named Kang, and he was down in the storm drain system last week. Something was moving down there. Ratten vielleicht? Big, too. Man-sized. Große Ratten? But it wasn't speaking any language Kang understood. Ja, welche Sprachen spricht er denn? Ich meine, wenn er jetzt nur Serbokroatisch spricht, ist es nicht verwunderlich, dass ihn hier in Hongkong keiner versteht. Oder er keinen versteht. But it wasn't... Kid beat feedback here as fast as he could. Dumbass dropped a storm drain key on the way out though. You wanna go looking for whatever it was, you'll have to get a new key from somebody else. Kang stole his from a city worker. Who else might have a key to the storm drains? There's a guy named Potter Lamb who's got keys to pretty much everything. He's somewhere between a cop and a handyman. Yuan also mentioned some elf woman with crazy colored hair who managed to scam a key. Ah, da weiß ich, wer das ist. Rainbow, vermute ich mal. He said she hunted paracritters down there. Yep, devil rats and shit. Ah, okay. Some of these BTLs you're selling look an awful lot like they came from Tong's shop. Yeah? So what? Why do you care? So if you stole these from Tong's, maybe you saw something I can use in my investigation. Yeah? I guess that's fair. I like this Broken Thumb Yuan was... It's like this. Broken Thumb Yuan was walking down the street and sees this guy go into Tong's joint right at closing time. Tall guy, hunched over. Had this shitty gray rain poncho draped over him. Okay, haben wir hier einen Augenzeugen. Now Yuan figured that was weird as hell, so he posts up and waits. He figures the guy will come out soon, cause Tong's closing up shop. Nothing for 15 whole minutes. Guy comes out, hustles down the street with nobody saying boo. I figure he was waiting for a nap in the crowds. Aha. Dass er unbemerkt wegkommt, okay. Jöns sees some blood smeared on the door, though, so he goes to check it out. Inside, total carnage. But you know what? Tonk's not gonna be using his gear anymore, so to hell with it. Pragmatische Haltung, kann ich nachvollziehen. Jöns jacks the lot of it. Business is business. You're damn right it is. That's all I know. The guy had to be the killer. Tall, gray rain poncho hunched over. Also smart about how he came and went. Ja, darauf geachtet, dass ihn keiner sieht. Okay. Can I look around this garage? Man, are you deaf? What the hell did I tell you? No, you goddamn well can't wander around our turf. Mumbling about something about idiots with no memory. Ja, okay. Etiquette Gang. Okay, er kennt I Cheng, dafür brauchen wir Socialite. Das ist ja, naja, egal. I'm on business for the Wimpone Elders. You're only here because they tolerate you. They hear you're blocking me, your ass is gonna get kicked all the way to Tsuan Wan. Was auch immer das ist. A ganger shifts nervously, glancing around at her allies. Okay, I'm listening. What kind of business are you on? Habe ich dir doch schon erzählt. Wie ist das mit Idiots with no memory? I'm investigating. Oder habe ich es nie erzählt? Ich bin der Idiot ohne Memory. I'm investigating the murders of the other elders. The gunfight with the HKPF might be related. Über den haben wir uns schon unterhalten mit dir. Mit den Gunfight. Alright, we only moved in here because all the Wampones are too shit scared of monsters and ghosts to come back in. The elders told us it was alright if we moved in here. Seemed happy to have us camped out, honestly. Look around, knock yourself out. Just stay out of the way of our business. Ja. Danke, du gef. Okay. Ja, dann schauen wir hier doch mal. Hier haben wir schon was. Okay. Möchtet ihr hierzu eine. Achso, hier war vielleicht der Firefighter. Okay. Bloodstains. Dried blood and bullet holes pockmark the floor, pillars and walls of the parking garage. Judging by the amount of blood staining the floor. Judging by the amount of blood staining the floor. Ach, das ist das Verb. Judging by the amount of blood staining the floor. Multiple people died here. To call the scene bloody would be to do it a disservice. This was a massacre of tremendous proportions. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Ja, ist schon richtig. Look at this console. Rector points to several scratches on the floor and in the pillar. These scratches look like they're from a long-bladed weapon, like a sword. Machete? 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 Ich habe ehrlich gesagt keine Ahnung, wie man Machete im Englischen ausspricht. Machete? Machete? Weiß nicht. That matches the wound on Tong's neck. Our killer must have found the HKPF in here and cut them apart. Alleine? With a number of bullet holes in the walls and cars around here, they must have just been spraying wildly. Okay. I don't relish the idea of fighting this killer in cramped quarters. Ehrlich gesagt, ich relische die Idee überhaupt nicht, ihn irgendwo zu bekämpfen. Wenn er hier mal so eben sechs Elite-Polizisten oder überhaupt Polizisten erschossen hat oder erstochen hat, während sie Rifles hatten. Dried blood and clots clog the drain. As you look closer, however, something catches your eye. An off-red color that doesn't match the hues of the gore around the drain. Bending closer, it appears to be a swollen nugget of some kind. Fish the item out. The nugget, upon closer inspection, is a chunk of some kind of synthetic ferroplastic. It's got ragged edges as if it was broken off of a larger object. A number of small markings are partially obscured by scratches. Achso, und da wir natürlich akademische Vorbildung haben, verstehen wir uns natürlich wunderbar. Ich liebe dieses. Du hast studiert? Okay, dann weißt du ja alles. Decipher the emblems. Also, wir können das übersetzen. Dann machen wir das mal. Brushing away some of the dust, you peer at a fragmentary bit of ferroplastic. The scratches and markings on the nuggets seem vaguely familiar, and after a moment it strikes you. You're not seeing the entirety of the markings, as the rest remain on the parent piece of ferrocrete. Ferrocrete. denke, fair place. Yeah, whatever. Were the scratches to be completed, I would read Renraku Kagaku Kabashuki Geisha. Ja, das hilft mir jetzt überhaupt nicht. The Japanese name for Renraku Applied Science. Aha. The branch of Renraku Asia responsible for material science. Okay. Oh. Oh, ja. Das ist ja hochinteressant. Da können wir... Okay, das sind es aber nicht die Storm Drains. Okay. Ist hier noch was? Sieht nicht so aus. So. Stört dich das, wenn wir das Stück mitnehmen? Hi. Nee, see you later. Rackt da ganz gemütlich. Okay. Gut, das hat uns jetzt noch nicht so viel weitergeholfen. Aber wir wissen, von wem wir den Schlüssel kriegen können. Rainbow, mein Schätzelein. Schnuffi, bist mal da. Hey, good to see you again. Something else I can help you with? Ja, aber wir haben leider nur die Wahl. do you have a key to the storm drains? Of course I do. How else would I get down to look for strange creepy crawlies, eh? What do you ask? Can I borrow it? I want to investigate something down there. Aye, sure. Watch your step down there, though. The drains are might bigger... Oh, this is good, this wind. Are might bigger than people normally expect. Best of luck. See you later, Rainbow. So, wie kommen wir denn jetzt zu den Das ist der Checkpoint. Ich will aber erstmal in die Storm Drains gucken. Wo kommen wir da nochmal hin? Die Storm Drains müssen ja irgendwie unten sein. Hier. Okay, jetzt sollte ich mal speichern. Wow. Okay. Da ist was. Was ist mit euch los? Alles okay mit euch? Ihr solltet irgendwie mal bei Olympia mitmachen. Leichtathletik irgendwie. Ihr könnt ziemlich schnell laufen. Okay, da ist was. Despite the darkness, you see something glitter at the edge of the drain. Looking closer, it appears to be a necklace chain of some kind. It's become caught in the drain's grate, narrowly avoiding falling down the deep pit. Take the necklace. Lifting the necklace out of the drain, you turn it over in your hand. It's a simple silver pendant on a chain. The silver pendant depicts a long-tailed bird in flight, a magpie. Oh, das ist hier. Okay. Good. Okay, dann ist Magpie vielleicht doch nicht irgendwie auf Business-Trip, sondern hier vielleicht irgendwo. Moment, ist sie hier vielleicht drin ersoffen oder so? Was war das für ein Geräusch? Oh, hier wohnt jemand. Oh, du bist ganz schön groß. Hallo. As you round the corner, you hear voices speaking just loudly enough for you to make out coherent sentences. The speakers are definitely not local. They speak with a slight Slavic accent, and their clothing is heavily armored. Bis auf das von der Dame hier. Ich vermute mal, seine Dame. Around them are a number of crates and boxes, all mostly filled. It looks like the group is packing up. Gut. Vasilisa. Jaroslav says the boat will be ready tomorrow morning. Upala. Seid ihr vielleicht Kollegen von denen, die wir erschossen haben? Das ist unangenehm. He's gotten everything arranged with the port authority. We move the goods to his warehouse. He'll handle loading them onto the ship and we can get paid right then and there. I'll be glad to be done with this filthy place. I will too. I hate having to hide in these damn drains. It stinks down here. I can hear the devil rats running down the walkways. It's a mess and it's disgraceful. We shouldn't have to put up with this bullshit. And Alexander still isn't back from his little trip. We'll have to leave him behind if he doesn't get back soon. I know, Galina, until Andre says we're in the clear from the triads, we can't be seen with the goods in the streets. They find us, we go back to Vladivostok in sausage casings. Those red dragon Mudaki don't screw around when it comes to protecting their turf. Who knows, maybe Alexander was stupid and they caught him. Either way, we'll have to lug his crap through the drains for a few clicks. The orc woman sniffs the air suspiciously and her eyes dart toward the dark tunnel you stand in. Naja, wir sitzen also so ziemlich offensichtlich. Before you have a chance to get out of sight, she locks eyes with you. The orc lifts her chin as she regards you, cracking her knuckles. What have we here? A curious little pest come looking for things that don't concern him. What do we do with pests, Galina? We break them, Vasilisa, and then we hammer a spike through each of their throats so anyone who sees their bodies knows not to meddle in our affairs. I suggest you stay where you are, pest. One point, Ellis, no, I'm down there. You start a fight, you're going to have every drone and cyber junkie on the streets crawling up your ass. I'm not here to meddle in anything. I'm just looking for a serial killer. Well, you found some, friend. Us. You think you can just walk out of here after finding us? Think again. Look around you. These storm... It's academic. Look around you. These storm drains act like resonance chambers. The exit on the streets will be like the mouth of a trumpet. They care if they hear gunfire on the turf. Okay, wir kennen uns also auch mit Akustik aus. Nicht nur mit Schriftzeichen und so ein Kram. Andre is obviously the four here. You're just enforcers and he doesn't want a scene while you're in one power garden. Das klingt lustig. You think I'm stupid? You think you can fast talk me with some stupid? He's right, Galina. You know how sounds can echo through these tunnels. Shit. Ja, hast du keinen Silencer für deine Shotgun, wa? Entschuldigung. You don't care about what we're doing? I have a job to do. This is incidental. So what do we want from us then? Did you have anything to do? Ne, das ist vielleicht eine blöde Frage. Is there anything you can tell me about the murders that I might not know? Die wissen doch gar nicht, was du nicht weißt. You think we get out a lot? I wouldn't have even known there were murders if I hadn't bothered to come out to get some Soykauf last week. It's none of our business and it isn't our problem. And I like it that way. Do you have anything to do? Nee, offensichtlich nicht. Are you stupid? Ja, ein bisschen schon. We're hiding down here so the Wampones don't know we've stolen from them. Why would we draw attention to ourselves? Jetzt ist es Wori, eben war es noch Wor. You would kill a Wampoon who got in your way, though. Of course we would. But they're not in our way. We just need the storm drains around here to move our gear through. Kowloon without being spotted. Why should we interfere with them? Ist ein guter Punkt. Okay, da geht's auch noch oben. Okay. Hier noch irgendwo irgendwas. Hier ist Blut. Habe ich da schon hingeguckt? Hier waren wir noch nicht. Oh, 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 ja. Ja, hier ist noch ein bisschen was. Hier liegen... Okay, Leichen rum. Body parts. A disgusting pile of stinking human remains smells strongly of blood and the first stages of decay. Seid ihr jetzt auch da? The arms, legs and organs here are heaped together like stacked firewood, leaking blood and gore across the floor. Was ist das, irgendein Kunstprojekt? Ist ja grausam. The parts contained therein appear to have been sliced away from the parent body. Hier will ich auch sagen. Rather than... Achso, sliced away from the parent body, rather than torn or bitten, okay. Judging by the clean edges of the cuts, the blade used to sever these parts was extremely sharp. This is a whole world of messed up, Gonzo. You think the killer stashed these here? They are stacked. They've been organized. This is our killer, alright? Nein, Gonzo, das ist nicht unser Killer. Das ist ein Haufen von Bodyparts. Du bist so herrlich dämlich. Looking closer at the pile, one part stands out. Okay. It's a severed forearm, and it's covered in tattoos. Words in Slavic language and a shining lighthouse adorn the forearm, and ring-like images are inked on each finger. On the back of the hand, there's a skull inside a square. This arm belongs to a war. These are criminal tattoos. The lighthouse shows he tried to escape from prison or planned to. The words say, all police are dogs. That skull inside a square means he served a prison term for robbery once. What's a war? Ah, hier hätten wir zuerst hinkommen müssen, okay. A war is a thief. The Vori V. Zakon is the name of the organization, Thieves in Law. They have strict codes and police their own. Okay, das macht das Spiel schon zum zweiten oder dritten Mal, dass wenn man irgendwas nicht in der richtigen Reihenfolge macht, dass dann die Dialoge sich darin nicht anpassen. Das ist ein bisschen schwach, finde ich. Also, weil eben in dem Gespräch ist das Spiel definitiv davon ausgegangen, dass wir hier zuerst waren und wir mussten hier nicht zuerst sein. Und das ist, also man hätte da vielleicht das War irgendwie noch erklären müssen oder so, oder einfach nicht das Wort nicht benutzen sollen. Also da hätte es noch einen Check geben müssen, ob wir das quasi schon wissen. Ah, egal. But they don't sever arms and leave them in a pile of gore. Ja, das machen nicht allzu viele Leute, das ist richtig. Okay, gut, dann gehen wir jetzt nochmal zu denen. You again, what now? Where was your friend headed when he disappeared? We found a keycard for a stockroom located behind Mrs. Yang's Jade Mountain restaurant. He went to check it out. We thought there might be something valuable in there. A little extra money for our time spent down here in the drains, ne? Do we have another key to the stockroom? Wollen wir ihr vielleicht sagen, dass der Typ da wahrscheinlich hinten liegt? Yes. There were several of them in the box. We just popped the lock off and took them all. Here. We don't have time for this. We have to move this gear. You want to play detective? Go right ahead. Okay. Gut. Wollen wir Ihnen einfach nie mitteilen, aber gut, okay. So, was haben wir denn jetzt hier? Das ist unübersichtlich. Stockholm Jackpoint. Okay, dann gehen wir jetzt mal zum Jackpoint. Da. Sehr aufgeräumt hier. Display Case, Open Server, okay. This bin is full of assorted chips, peripherals and add-on modules for Cyberdecks. They don't seem to be arranged in any coherent fashion and are spread across the felt surface. Search through the bin. You sift through the display case, searching for anything that might prove interesting. Isabel peers past you into the bin as you search. That's interesting. There's a lot of storage memory, I/O handlers and active memory in this bin. I'm not seeing any MPCP hardware response increased chips or anything related to the hot shit decking Magpie was supposed to be into. In fact, you couldn't even build a full deck with this. Without the MPCP, it would just be a glorified comlink. What do you think it means? Well, if I had to guess, I'd say somebody's cleaned her out. MPCP, response increase, biofeedback filters and all that. They're easy to move, expensive and highly illegal. All the rest of this crap is good, but it's nothing you couldn't pick up at any electronics shop. You'd have to know what you're looking for, though. Only a good decker would know what they're seeing. Could Magpie have taken them with her? Woher soll sie das denn wissen? Isabel gestures toward one of the other displays. A pair of small cyberdecks sit inside the locked case. I guess so, but if she did that, why would she leave the completed cyberdecks? No, I think this was theft. Ja, warum dann haben die Leute dann nicht die completed cyberdecks auch mitgenommen? Okay. The front of the service case hangs open. The inner machinery quiet and without power. A clipboard is stuck to the side by a piece of duct tape. It's papers filled with a long list of programs and their prices. A quick glance over the program sheet reveals names like Bugs, Bugs, Bugs and Black Hammer. Undoubtedly, this was Magpie's attack program, storage machine. Somebody's removed the drives, and it sure wasn't Magpie. Here, look. The main drives were disconnected properly, but it looks like she modded the server to have a backup drive when its own battery-based power with its own battery-based power supply. If it was Magpie, she would have taken that too. Crap! This is a Fuji XB1000, and it looks like the battery power ran out a while ago. The XB1000s are constant write drives. They are dirt cheap and have a ton of capacity, but if they run out of power, they lose their data. This is also unpraktisch. We are not gonna be able to get anything off the drive. Das ist aber wirklich ein unpraktisches Gerät. Also jetzt mal ehrlich. Naja. Ja. Zum Glück kenne ich mich mit sowas nie aus. Magpie's Desk. Magpie's Desk is the kind of messy most people only associate with rat's nests, hoarders and deckers. The surface of the desk is littered with cigarette butts, half-finished cans of Soykov, and scraps of electronics. A towering pile of empty instant noodle bowls sits next to it. Their sides are blazoned, whatever, with Honest Wong's instant old-time lemon, and depict a line of top-hat-wearing caterpillars dancing with canes. Yeah, this. Hey, awesome! I didn't think anybody but me liked Honest Wang's noodles. Flavor like you've never tasted in a package of instant noodles, I promise. What the fuck? Gobbit taps the side of one container. See? This one's cheese curry broccoli. I don't know why it never caught on, honestly. I can smell that stuff across the entire boat when you cook it. It's a bit like old socks with a side of vinegar. The first time I smelled it, I thought you were fumigating. Okay, jetzt müssen wir hier, okay. Psch, Isabel, your main problem is that you have no idea what's delicious and what isn't. Expand your horizons. There's a whole world of deliciousness waiting for you at every corner store. Okay. Glaubt ihr, dass das jetzt der richtige Zeitpunkt dafür ist? My horizons are fine where they are, thanks. After all, I can still tell if I'm eating food or cardboard. That's one of those little things I'd like to hold on to. Search the desk. You gingerly root around in the desk, doing your best to avoid the more disgusting piles and spills. It isn't easy. The desk's drawers are stuffed to overflowing with receipts, cigarette packs, optical chips, and cables. Most of the contents are boring, useless, and disgusting. While searching one of the bottom drawers, however, a low-quality tin lockbox catches your eye. Someone has pried the latch off, leaving a ragged hole where a lock should be. The interior of the box has several sleeves for storing keycards, all of which are empty. A small note is taped to the interior of the box. Spare stockroom keys. The door is in the rear of Mrs. Young's restaurant. Do not lose these. Use only if I'm not available to open the stockroom. Okay. You search Magpie's bathroom. There's not much in here. Toothbrush, toilet paper, some hairpins, and a collection of cheap makeup. The combination bath-shower unit. Das sieht mir nur noch eine Schau. However, has minor flakes of a dry reddish substance near the drain. Blood, dried blood. Prying open the drain cover, it looks like quite a bit of it was shed as well. The blood hasn't been fully washed away. It looks like there was a cursory attempt to clean out the bath, but they missed washing it all away. It's a clever move, though. If Magpie is dead, a body drained of blood would be a lot easier to move without leaving evidence. This doesn't seem to match the killer's other scenes, though. I'm not certain I trust the elders to tell us the whole story. Nee, ich auch nicht. Let's not inform them of this finding just yet. If any of them know more than they are saying, they may go to ground and cover their tracks with greater diligence. Okay. Na gut. So, wo war jetzt das komische Restaurant? Hier. Sind wir jetzt schon... Das ist nicht das Restaurant, glaube ich. Da sind wir schon, wir sind schon quasi in dem Raum, wo wir hinwollen. Yep. Hallo? It's a stockroom, alright. Food. Mementos. Drei Plates. Despite the table's crude construction, kann man so sagen, an artfully laid meal awaits the owner. Several small dishes are filled with pickled vegetables, while a larger plate is arranged with long slices of raw meat. Okay, das muss unsichtbar sein. Raw meat. Okay. The meat is pale pinkish white, like raw pork, and is covered in a light soy marinade. Okay, wenn ich jetzt an die ganzen Verstümmelungen und Sachen denke, das ist jetzt aber nicht hier... oder? Poking at the raw meat, you discover that it's surprisingly tender. What's more, it has the faint aroma of marinade, as if deliberately prepared. Nee. Erstmal ist es nicht unseres, zweitens weiß ich nicht, was das für Fleisch ist, und drittens könnte das durchaus humanoides Fleisch sein, wenn ich mir die Leichen so überlege. Ich meine, ist es wahrscheinlich nicht, aber raw meat, ich meine, wer macht denn Vegetables und wer isst denn rohes Fleisch? Also ich nicht. Also gut. Zumindest nicht im ganzen Stück nicht. Also, ne? Wisst schon. This box is packed full of odds and ends. It nearly overflows with a collection of knickknacks, souvenirs and assorted personal effects. There's no rhyme or reason to the collection of items. They appear to have been thrown in haphazardly. Among the contents are charms from various temples, a wooden mask and a paper fan. What? Examine the mask. The wooden mask is extremely light. It's been painted a pale white and the surface is almost as smooth as porcelain. Delicate features, a lifted eyebrows, Delicate features and lifted eyebrows are matched with bright red lips and delicately carved teeth. What? The teeth have been stained a deep black. Das wirkt sehr realistisch. Examine the charms. The small charms are square cloth packets, each approximately 1 inch wide and 3 inches tall. They come in a variety of bright colors and are embroidered with characters for prosperity, peace, wealth and protection. Inside each appears to be folded paper prayer of fortune, written in Japanese. Examine the paper fan. Ist das so ein, ist das so wie so, wie so eine Verkleidung? Also so eine Maske, so ein Fächer? Unfolding the fan, you tilt up toward the light to examine it. The image depicts an East Asian city from the 19th century or earlier. Curved roofs at sunset beside a deep blue river. Two ships sail down the river, which is in turn spanned by a long wooden bridge. In the foreground, laborers carry buckets along the shore as a man on horseback rides in the opposite direction. In the distance, a pair of large red buildings dominate the city skyline, one large temple hall and a five-tiered pagoda. As you step away from the box, you hear a slight click in the distance, the sound of the door slats shutting. You are no longer alone in the stockroom. Okay. Oh, hi. Ja, greif mal die zuerst an. Es läuft Isabel weg, das würde ich auch machen. Okay, du hast da ein Schwert in der Hand, ne? Sehe ich das richtig? Standing before you is a man clad in heavy armor and bearing a katana on his hip. His skin is an ashen gray, his eyes dead white. His teeth are jagged and appear quite sharp. This is no man. This is a ghoul. Und du wohnst hier. Es ist eine sehr gute Idee gewesen, dass wir das nicht gegessen haben. Ach du liebe Güte. Du siehst noch vergleichsweise vernünftig aus für einen Ghoul. Aber the ghoul's blind eyes search back and forth as it regards you. It cannot see you, but you have a sense that it knows exactly where you are at all times. Ah, a hired gun. No doubt brought to bear against me by the Wampoan elders. A means by which they can lift the curse plaguing them. I salute you, tenacity, but I wonder, will you hear me out before raising your weapon to kill me? What? You're a ghoul, and you're talking. Ja, so warum nicht? You don't seem interested in eating me. Yes. I'm not only talking, I'm reasoning as well. Jetzt gehst du auf das Talking-Ding ein, was ich aber nicht gesagt habe. Auch Spiel, das könnte dann ein bisschen besser, die Dialoge könntet ihr ein bisschen besser, also Dialog-Trees könntet ihr ein bisschen besser handhaben, finde ich. Ich meine, das passt auch, aber trotzdem, also das ist, ne, wirkt ein bisschen unelegant. I'm reasoning, and since you have not attempted to kill me, your own higher faculties are engaged. I'm a curiosity to you. The ghoul bares his teeth, breath rasping over them as he inhales. You wish to know not only what I am, but what I have done. As for who, you may call me Gaichu. Okay? You know who you are. You're the one killing the Wampoan elders. You are correct. I have killed all of the Wampoan elders to date, though only Elder Magpie was according to my initial plan. I regret the death of the other elders, but it was necessary. What does Gaichu mean? Harmful insect. It's the name I have taken for myself since the word is usually applied to pests, especially ones who drink blood, such as leeches and mosquitoes, die alle ein kleines Tucken kleiner sind als du. Außerdem keine Schwerter tragen, normalerweise. The first character means injury or evil influence, and the second means insect or worm. This affair began simply enough. Ich nehme an, das ist, wäre das, was gekommen wäre, wenn wir gesagt hätten, explain yourself. This affair began simply enough. As you may surmise, I am not someone who can be seen in public without great risk. Wampoa Garden is an excellent place to hide, no police or triad presence, and minimal interest in things that lurk in the shadows. Unfortunately for me, Elder Nick discovered me through communion with her spirits. Rather than kill or chase me away, she came to me with a proposition. Nick and the other elders were having problems with one of their number. An elder named Magpie had been holding many of their plans hostage and would not budge. They could not remove Magpie, however, because his services were too useful to the Wampoans at large. Nick offered me payment to dispose of Magpie, and I accepted. You didn't clean up all of her blood. I found some in her drain. Ah, unfortunate. I thought I was careful enough. Having it on my hands must have obscured my sense of smell enough that I missed the last remnants in the drain. Stimmt, du kannst es ja nie sehen. I disposed of Magpie's body by emptying the blood in her bathroom. Then I cut her up into more portable pieces. Sehr pragmatisch. Those were placed in a plastic tarp, which I took to the storm drains and hid. Kaiju nonchalantly waves a hand, his tone flat and unconcerned. It's unfortunate, but my survival depends upon consumption of raw metahuman flesh. Letting such nourishment go to waste would be a foolish error. That doesn't explain everything. Afford me a moment, and I will explain the rest to you. I contacted the elders, not in person, of course, and they arranged to exchange payment. I assumed that since the job was done, Nick would be a woman of her word. I was mistaken. I arrived at the nearby parking garage the elders had told me about. They had cleared out the other Wampoans under some pretense, though I'm not sure what ruse they used. The elders never showed up. Instead, several members of the Hong Kong police force arrived. They were more heavily armed than usual, so I suspect they knew something of my nature. Ah, hat dich also verpetzt. I saw scarring on the concrete from bullets and a blade. You killed them with a sword? At my hands, yes. This is nicht schlecht. My blindness precludes the use of ranged weapons. Unfortunate, since I was an excellent shot before I became infected. But my skills in grappling and kenjutsu have only increased. A battle of swords and a clash of souls. Mine was stronger than theirs, and they perished. The betrayal of that sword cannot stand. Not only was I not paid for my time and effort, the Wampoan elders treated me like a common animal. And I'm so much more than that. Reputation is everything, and I had none. I had hoped to build a network of contacts so that I would be able to continue finding work, but with that treachery, my hope were dashed. I decided to become the monster that they feared. Ja, ich meine, vom Prinzip ist, also, im Prinzip hat sie dich hintergangen, nur warum hast du Nick denn nicht also, ich hätte dann ja immer, wäre Nick, oder wie auch immer sie heißt, NG da, das erste Ziel gewesen. One by one I have eliminated them. They know how to contact me and could have ended the nightmare at any time by making amends. I would have asked for more money, but I would have seized my hunt. Yet they did not. Instead, they contacted you, no doubt asking you to eliminate me where the police had failed. So I ask you, what now? What will you do? Will you attempt to finish what the Wampoans started, or will you treat me with the same humanity I have shown you? Let me ask you some questions. Very well. What would you like to know? Is this from your armor? Ah, yes. I felt a ragged edge on one shoulder plate. I assume it was removed when one of the police officers shot me with his rifle. The hazards of war include unkempt attire, unfortunately. Did you eat the elders? Some of them. Not all. My condition requires that I consume raw metahuman flesh. I do not require a great deal to survive, perhaps 3 to 4 pounds per week. 2 Kilo Fleisch pro Woche. Das ist mehr als ich esse. Also Fleisch. Aber gut, ich bin auch kein Ghoul.
Noch nicht, ja.
Kilo Fleisch. Obwohl, nee, übernehmen wir mal kurz überlegen. 7 Tage, das sind 300. Ein bisschen weniger. Nee, hast recht, das ist nicht viel. Ein bisschen weniger als 300 Gramm pro Tag. Nee, das ist. Das ist, denke ich mal. Würde mich mal interessieren, was so ein durchschnittlicher Mensch isst an Fleisch pro Tag. Aber 300 Gramm klingt nicht so übermäßig viel. Nee. Consequently, there's vastly more supply than demand. Why? Why would the elders have you killed instead of paying you?
Any number of reasons. They are notorious cheapskates.
Ja, aber die müssen doch dafür bezahlen. Die werden doch die Polizei dafür bezahlt haben müssen, oder nicht? Oder in unserem Fall uns, beziehungsweise Kindly Cheng. Oder nicht?
Well, they are notorious cheapskates and will always try to save money when dealing with outsiders. It could be their natural inclination toward profit. They may regard me as subhuman and therefore unworthy of respect. It could be that they felt I was too dangerous to allow to live. It could even be that they simply did not like me.
Fällt's mir. Also ein bisschen.
The net result is the same, however. They reneged on a deal we brokered and attempted to have me killed. A message must be sent. Blood must be paid. As they have hired you to kill me, they have obviously not learned their lesson.
Ja, ich meine, ich stimme dir da in allem zu. Vom Prinzip ist das richtig. Das so funktionieren Verträge in den Schatten. Meiner Meinung nach.
If I let you live, what will you do?
Kill the rest of the elders and anyone else they see sent to exterminate me. It is a matter of survival. Should I ever have the opportunity to work freelance again? Potential employers need to understand the price of betrayal.
Ja, deswegen macht man das. Also, in dieser Welt.
These murders are my curriculum vitae and revenge. I've made my decision.
Oh,
what then will you do? How will the story end?
Come and work with me. I can be your face. Because I'm pretty, pretty. And you are pretty ugly. Come and work with me. I can be your face.
Curious offer. And what of the elders? Will you allow me to the satisfaction of killing them?
Hey, hey, hey. Ja, Problem. Dilemma. Einerseits, von deiner Sicht, ja. Also, ne, du müsstest das machen. Andererseits haben wir einen Auftrag von ihnen. Und es ist für unsere Reputation nicht besonders gut, wenn wir unsere Auftragkiller, ohne dass sie uns hintergehen, einfach übrig. Also, da wird sich nämlich keiner mehr uns Aufträge geben.
I want to see what I have to say first.
Das klingt gut.
I would counsel you not to believe their words, but you have the sound of one who is wary as a matter of course.
Very well.
Let us wait until a bit later in the night. Most pedestrians will be off the street, and it will be easier for us to approach the Wumpoa without being noticed.
Sounds like a good plan. Sekunde mal kurz. Okay, wieder da. So, ne, dann machen wir mal. Bist du jetzt dabei? Ja. Hm. Okay, dann gehen wir hier vielleicht mal den... Geh mal lang. Hier steht ja der Kollege... Steht hier zum Glück gerade nicht. Sehr gut. Tatsächlich gerade keiner hier. Na, dann schauen wir mal, was die Elder so zu sagen haben. Wo sind sie denn? Elders? Ah, hier. Okay.
As you approach, Elder Nick's eyes widen. Her mouth falls open and the veins on her neck bulge.
What? Are you doing? You've brought this thing into our home. Quick, kill it before it kills us.
Potter hefts his pistol warily, but does not aim it at anyone.
Yeah, I have to say, this isn't a good idea. Why the hell is a ghoul in here? And why is it wearing armor?
Calm yourselves. I'm not an it, and your elders know this intimately.
Good evening, Elder Nick. I can smell your fear, and I'm glad of this. It means you are learning the price of betrayal.
Whoa. What the hell is going on in here? Can someone explain to me why the ghoul is talking?
Yes, he's a talking ghoul. Deal with it.
Gaichu had a contract with the elders and they betrayed him.
You dare to accuse us of conspiring with a monster and covering it up? You're insane. The very idea is preposterous.
Porter nods at the elders, looking back to you with a wary expression. I'm interested to hear what kind of evidence you have to support this theory, Gonzo. As far as I can tell, this monster killed Tong and the others, and that makes him a threat that should be eliminated.
The elders hired Gaichu to kill Elder Magpie and make it look like she disappeared.
You believe this vermin? This creature that feasts on metahuman flesh, that kills and dismembers our tribesmen? You're a naive and foolish man, if that's the case. What proof do we have that Magpie is dead?
Nick, please. In matters where an elder is accused of breaking our law, the other elders generally judge them. In matters where all of them have been accused, I'm authorized to act as a judge. Make your case, Shadowrunner.
Ich hoffe, dass wir das alles sagen können.
I found Magpie's necklace in the storm ruins.
This is definitely Elder Magpie's. If you found it in the storm ruin, that's suspicious, but hardly proof on its own.
Of course it's not proof. The number of things lost down storm drains in Hong Kong must number in the tens of thousands per year. While unusual, it's hardly evidence of foul play.
There was a large amount of blood in a shower drain.
So what? Perhaps she cut herself and washed the cut off. Or perhaps you are mistaken about it being blood. You're simply guessing as to what happened.
That's true, it's a guess, and even if it's her blood, that doesn't prove that the elders hired the ghoul to kill her.
Ja, das ist nicht völlig falsch.
Porter gives Elder Ip a sidelong glance. The elders have always protected Whampoa Garden to the best of their ability. She hasn't been seen in a month, not by anyone. She wouldn't just disappear like that.
Nee, das ist auch nicht gerade ein gutes Argument.
That may be unlikely, but it's hardly impossible. You haven't established that the elders were involved. All you've done is make suppositions about it. What proof do we have that we hired and betrayed this creature? I won't sit by and listen to idle-like accusations without any kind of concrete evidence to back it up. What about the fight with the Hong Kong police force?
How do you mean?
What does that have to do with the elders and the ghoul?
Evidence in the garage points to a fight with someone using a sword.
We allowed the police into my poor garden because they were hunting someone. They never told us who or why they were looking for their quarry. It didn't have anything to do with us.
It was only in the garage to collect payment from them. The ordinary residents were warned of the HKPF's arrival and were gone by the time I arrived.
That's suspicious, I admit. It still doesn't prove the elders knew it was the ghoul.
This is a piece of Gaichu's armor I found in the garage. The markings on it prove it.
You point out the armor's markings?
Mm-hmm.
This is from his armor, definitely. But how does it prove that the elders knew of the ghoul's existence?
Your police officers were abnormally armed and armored with much heavier gear than a normal patrol. They were armed with armor-piercing discarding sabot rounds. That's hardly standard issue. Lesser weapons would have broken that armor plate. Wouldn't have broken that armor plate. If all they were looking for was a common fugitive, why be prepared for a fight of that magnitude?
Obviously, they knew what they were searching for. That doesn't mean we did.
You impounds don't allow police inside the area. Why make an exception this time?
The police were polite and asked our permission to enter. They were hunting a non-Wampo, and that was reason enough for us to allow them in.
That doesn't add up.
Nick, why would the police ask us for entry now? They've never been polite before, and they've always tried to force their way in here. It just doesn't ring true to me. Did you ask them to come in order to hunt down this ghoul?
Preposterous. Porter, you know what our community is like. We wouldn't lie over something like this.
This ghoul has been lying the entire time, trying to cover his tracks. He still brutally murdered several elders.
Stimmt.
That's true. Those murders were vicious and cruel.
I don't see any way to explain that away. This ghoul is a monster for how he killed Tong and the others.
Body was missed too, but he died quickly from a sword blow to the neck.
Tong wasn't touched, there was no astral residue of pain or fear. He didn't even feel the blow.
That's correct. I struck a single blow while his back was to me. His death was instant. Regrettable that he had to die for your folly, Nick, but necessary to protect my reputation.
You cannot believe what these people say. They are not to be trusted, and even if this is true, he still killed Tong.
Maybe so, Nick, but a monster would not take Tong's suffering into account. He may be a killer, but is not heartless.
The scene of Tong's murder, like the others, was a deliberate sham. It was made to look more horrific than it was.
I believe you. The blood smeared on the walls, the removal of his skin. That's a scene designed to evoke horror, not a scene of an actual fight. Elders, what do you have to say in response?
This is a farce. We have dedicated ourselves to protecting the Wampoan tribe and everyone who lives in Wampoa Garden. Do you really believe outsiders and monsters over our word? We who have only tried to end the killings? You've been duped, Porter. You and this Shadowrunner.
I concur.
Porter, you know me. You know the kind of person I am. I wouldn't be party to the killing of another elder.
I can't believe we're even entertaining the notion that we have to defend ourselves. We should be disposing of this ghoul instead.
If you think I'll forget this, you're solely mistaken. I will not tolerate this kind of insult.
The elders were all too happy to have the red spears move into the garage, almost like they wanted to keep anyone curious about the fight away.
That's right, Ip.
You even told me not to go find out what happened with the fight. So,
you said the Red Spear gangers were moving in and to leave them alone. Why would you tell me not to look into it?
I was only trying to protect you from the Red Spears. They're dangerous, which is why I wanted to deal with them directly.
Das hast du aber nicht getan. Magpie's gear was missing, obviously missing.
Why didn't Ip tell me that? He would have had to have noticed, and Magpie's shop is locked up. Why didn't he want me investigating?
Pure supposition. You think it proves something that I didn't notice equipment was missing? Magpie's shop is always a horrible mess.
Dang, you did a full inventory of Magpie's matrix servers. You assured us everything was running fine and you would be able to continue her work. I find it hard to believe you missed something as obvious as missing equipment, especially while searching a stock.
All right, I think I have some idea of what's going on here.
And what do you believe the real story is?
Gaichu seems to be telling the truth.
Elders, too many facts don't add up. You are obviously hiding something, possibly a great deal, from the rest of the tribe. I'm sorry, but I have to take you into custody until the community can decide the extent and manner of your punishment.
Death would seem appropriate to me, especially given that they kept this charade even to you, one of their most trusted citizens.
Don't you dare talk to me like that, you disgusting beast.
It begins to raise his weapon.
Porter reaches out to stop him. Ip reluctantly stops.
Ip, no. Don't make this any worse than it is.
Thank you, Gonzo. I'll make certain that justice is meted out.
Whatever.
You are free to go and I will ensure payment is delivered to you, so long as you take Gaichu with you. I can't have him staying here.
He will be coming with me.
As I exit the Wampoa into the sweltering night, I confess I am unhappy with the decision to allow the Wampoan elders to live. We should have killed them, if it for no other reasons than to maintain our reputation.
Nini, deine Reputation.
Uns haben sie ja nicht hintergangen. Also,
Ja, uns haben sie genau genommen auch hintergangen, ja. Aber andererseits, wir haben sie ja der hiesigen Justiz quasi zugeführt. Also haben sie ja quasi ihre Bestrafung erhalten. Eigentlich ist das okay und ehrlich gesagt, wahrscheinlich, wenn wir sie umgebracht hätten, das hätte wahrscheinlich nur mehr Ärger gemacht. Außerdem wissen wir nicht, wie Kindly Cheng das gefunden hätte. I have to learn to accept my decisions. Das ist ein bisschen arrogant. That's why I let them live. That's not how we do things. Ja, ist es ja offensichtlich, aber... What's done is done. Let it lie. This is a fair point. This is a fair point. You have done me a great service and I will follow your lead. Okay, habe ich auch den Eindruck, das ist eigentlich die Antwort auf was anderes, aber shall we leave this place? I'm eager to be done with my poor garden. Ja, ich in der Tat auch. Hier ist ja auch niemand mehr. Ja, dann würde ich sagen, gehen wir. Was ich ein bisschen schade finde, kommen wir hier nochmal hin. So, Rainbow aus den Augen verloren haben, das ist ein bisschen... Ich meine, wir haben auch noch den Schlüssel, den wir, oder die Keycard, die wir ihr zurückgeben müssen. Und dabei sie vielleicht aus Versehen nach ihrer Telefonnummer fragen müssen oder so. Nope, nicht mehr hier. Ah, oh, Mensch, ja, ist aber das Gleiche. Der Händler ja auch weg? Yep, okay. Naja, müssen sich wahrscheinlich alle besprechen, was sie jetzt machen. Okay, dann fahren wir nach Hause. Haben wir alles gemacht? Sieht so aus. Okay. The MTR rockets noiselessly toward Heoi along the edge of Kowloon Bay. The black water glitters in the night with the light of 1,000 reflected storefronts. Gaichu stares sightlessly out the window, one hand pressed to the glass. The plot of the elders is exposed and Porter Lam is in your debt. You have a new ally and the respect of the Wompones. Sehr schön. Sometimes everything goes right on a job. You count yourself lucky, this was one of those times. Okay. Spiel. Ah, okay, ein bisschen gedauert. Claim payment for your runs. Ja, okay, das machen wir dann beim nächsten Mal. Haben wir also die Morde aufgeklärt und wie sich das gehört, den Mörder in unser Team aufgenommen. Ja, da würde ich sagen, sehen wir uns hier beim nächsten Mal wieder mit mehr Shadow in Hongkong. Bis dahin, tschüss.